In today's video, I'm going to create a web application using React.js, then create a simple React component for a simple machine learning model using TensorFlow.js. Finally, I'm going to publish the example model as a static HTML page into GitHub Pages. The final result is a React.js app which expects some input values to be entered along with its corresponding outputs, so it can be trained and be able to predict a new output given a value that you entered. Hi, I am Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AEM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so that you don't miss a thing. So let's start. React.js is a JavaScript framework for building user interfaces, which is mostly used for creating single page applications. I am going to use it in this video so I can create a simple static but interactive site for deploying into GitHub Pages. First, let's create a simple React application by using npx create react app and then the name for the new application. In this case, simple React.js TensorFlow. Once that's finished, you will see a couple of folders, like the src folder in which we store all our source files, the public one for the static stuff like images, robots.txt, or the entry page into our application from the browser, and many more. Let's change the directory to the newly created node project and then start the dev server so that we can make changes in the code and see the results on the browser. Let's create a simple empty component for the TensorFlow example.js and then add it into the app.js. I will also create a CSS with some styles. I will add the Immutability helper and restart the server. I will add the state for the value pairs to hold an array of inputs and outputs, so that we can train our new model and the state to hold the properties related to the model. Then I add the handlers for managing changes and adding new items on the inputs and outputs. Changes into the model properties and two empty handlers, one for training the model and another for predicting new values. First, I add the controls for training the model by iterating over the value pairs properties and rendering a field per input and output. Then I create a button for adding new items and another one for training the model, which are already connected to their respective handlers. Finally, for the prediction controls, I create an input field to allow the user to enter a value so that its output can be predicted, a field to show the predicted value, and a button to perform the actual prediction, which will only be enabled once the model has been trained. TensorFlow.js is a JavaScript library that allows us to train and use machine learning models on the browser and Node.js. I am going to use the simple example model located in TensorFlow's GitHub repository. In there, they are declaring a pretty simple model that just has one layer, one hidden unit, and also that it will receive just one input. Then the model will be compiled using the mean squared error loss function and stochastic gradient descent. Finally, they declare a couple of arrays of data or tensors and finally fit or train the model, and then predict and output given an input value tensor. So what this code really does is that it will take a couple of numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, the array or tensors for the x-axis, and 1, 3, 5, 7, the tensor for the y-axis, then create a function or, well, a line or equation that tries to approximate and pass near most of the y numbers iteratively using the loss function. So it will look at the current predictive power of the model, let's say an horizontal line, and calculate the distance between the given numbers and that particular line using the loss function. Then what gradient descent will do is minimize this distance by starting to make the aforementioned line or function move little by little as near as possible to most of the points by adjusting some of its parameters, like the slope, for example. So let's add TensorFlow.js into our React application. Import tf.js, and on the train handler, add the rest of the code from the TensorFlow.js site, replacing the hard-coded values with the properties that we already defined for the value pairs and model state. Set the trained property to true and add a little text so that the user knows when to start predicting. Move the rest of the code into the predict handler and set the predicted value property to the output from the model and change the hard-coded value to the property provided by the user. Now go into the browser, click on train, and let's see if our intuition is right about the values that the model should predict. Close enough. Now let's publish our code into GitHub Pages. For that, let's make sure that the package.json file has the homepage property set to dot. Let's generate the static site using npm run build. Go into GitHub and create a new repository for the project. Initialize your local repository for the code, add all the files, commit the code, add the repository so that you can push the code into your repo, and finally push the code. Given that one way to have a GitHub page working for you is by creating a branch with the special name gh-pages, create a new branch with this name, which won't have any relation with the code on the master branch. Delete everything but the build directory and move its content to the root of your Git repository. Then, again, add everything, commit the changes, and push them into your new gh-pages branch. Go into your page by using your GitHub username and the name for the repository we just created, and test that the application is working. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you liked the video, please hit subscribe.